Hi, my name is Mark Steger, Director of Professional Services with American Barcode and RFID. Today we're going to show you our abcscan.net product, and specifically we're going to use it to track servers and do inventory of servers. There's many different ways you can use this product, and this is just one of them. So let's begin. The first step of the process is to get our existing data into the system, and we did this by copying it out of an Excel spreadsheet and pasting it in here. You can see the current location is listed in the column to the left, the barcoded asset ID, and then a description of the server or switch and so on. So what we're going to demonstrate today is we're going to send this data to a mobile device, and then we're going to go out into the actual server room and do the inventory and show how easy that is and how well that works. The first step that we have to do is to sign in, and I've already done that, and the next step is to just pick inventory as what we're wanting to do. So now the system is asking you for the location that you want to inventory, and it's displaying an item prompt that you can scan into. So we'll go ahead and scan our location. Here's what's happened. The system knows from us inputting it that these items are supposed to be in this rack. So it's given me a list. So all it wants me to do now is to scan each one off the list. So we'll start with the top one. The next one. And so on. As you can see, the system says that there's no more servers, but if you look in the real world, there's one more left. So that must be a new one someone added. So we'll just type in the asset ID number to that one. System asks, do you want to add it? This is a configurable option in the system. You can allow an end user in the field to add one or not to add one. We'll say yes. And then it wants a description. And this one is an IBM server, so we'll just really quickly type that in. And now that server will be added to the database when we go to sync it back. So the next step that we would need to do is go to our next item. We'll scan the location up at the top here. And then it will bring us a list of everything that's supposed to be in this rack. And as you see that there's two servers in this rack. So we'll just scan those off. And so on. So for the next step, we're done with our inventory. We'll just go back to the PC and sync it up. Once this is completed, we'll go into the View Edit database screen and we'll see that we've done an inventory of our server room, and we'll see that new server that we added. So let's go ahead and do that. So the first tab is the History tab. You can see the history of everything that was ever inventoried, and this is the inventory that we just did. If you go into the items, you'll see that you have everything in its proper place, including a new server that wasn't there before with the description of IBM. This is the one that we added. And if you had added any new locations, any new server racks, they'd be there. So that's about the size of it. If you want to do a quick and easy inventory of your server room or any other high-value asset, abcscan.net can help you out. Thank you for your time.